Hello everyone, and greetings from Germany. So I guess that right there is a spoiler. I actually did make it to Germany safely, and before I did, there was a lot going on in Washington, D.C. So this week, some of the things I'm going to talk about are: I see a lot of monuments more than one time, a girl points at a painting, and I also eat a lot of Mexican food.
Margaritas and beers and queso.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy my week in review. So, the CBYX program orientation started this week in D.C., and I went down a couple of days earlier to meet some of the other participants. We were staying in a hostel, and then we were just going to tour the town, because I haven't been there since I was a young kid, and I kind of wanted to see all the monuments and all the cool touristy stuff. Actually, I had to go down to Atlanta first, and then back up to D.C., and the flight to Atlanta, there was nobody on it, like nobody. I have no idea how the airline was making any money, especially because the reason that I was flying on that flight was because it was from a voucher from another flight that they screwed up. So, God, no, they were not making any money on that one. After I got to D.C., flight landed probably around midnight, and I took the metro all the way to the hostel, and it was about 90 degrees and raining. So I had a jacket on, soaked, and then I was hot on top of that, and man, I was just sweating like crazy. Plus, I was tired. It's fairly miserable. Got up the next day, and we met with the other people in the hostel, had some pancakes, and we went down to the mall. We saw the White House.
We knocked, but Obama wasn't home.
Of course, the Washington Monument, as well as the World War II Monument. We also saw the Vietnam War Memorial, and of course, the Lincoln Memorial. And there was some paint that got splattered on the memorial. However, it wasn't that much, but it didn't seem like they were really cleaning it off either. And lastly, we also saw the Korean War Memorial. Now, this is where some things get a little bit interesting. When we went to the museums, first we saw the Holocaust Museum, and it was okay. I wouldn't compare it really to the one in Berlin, which was clearly a lot better than the one in Washington, D.C. Next, we also went to the Air and Space Museum, which had a bunch of planes. Pretty cool. But the really interesting one is when we got to some of the art museums, and I'll show you why. So first we see this painting of a guy with a sweet mustache, and then we see this statue of a lady riding a bull backwards on a pool of dolphins, which we just thought denied the laws of nature, and also found it extremely fascinating. So after we were done with the older art inside, we stumbled upon some newer art outside, and we decided to critique it like the expert art critiques we were. So I'm just gonna let the commentary run on this one and just, yeah.
It's weird.
It's cool though. It's
a donut. It looks like the jaws is gonna eat the bird that's upside down box. And what appears to be a cardboard box.
It's definitely a cardboard box on a saddle. What is the, is that a shoe up there?
It's like a whale, like inside of a
This is just weird. Sam, what kind of tree is this? If you could name this tree, what would it be?
Inspiration.
Inspiration. It's an inspiration tree. I would agree with that. It inspires me to do things.
Leaves of hope just come off of it.
Leaves of hope, yes. Which are non-existent at this point, because
yeah,
I have no
hope. Because
there is no hope anymore. It's
like
a Pac-Man ghost.
Like
the ladder to chair had a baby. This is what it would be.
That's what it would be.
So after a long day of walking around the mall, walking around the museums, we decided we need something to eat, and we were going to meet up in front of the White House with a bunch of the other CBYXers that were in the area to go to dinner. And when we got in front of the White House, we were interested in what we saw. That's right, a bunch of people protesting the war in Egypt. I found it fascinating. Some of the other people, not quite so much. They were a little thrown off guard with the fact that we were like in the middle of this protest, but protesters were peaceful and no one was hurt or anything like that. So then we walked a long way again up to the restaurant in which we had our dinner. I don't remember the name of the restaurant. It was a Mexican restaurant. I ordered some enchiladas. They don't do enchiladas the same way as they do in Indiana, out in D.C. And I gotta say, they weren't really that great. And then after that, we walked all the way back to the mall, and because no one knew what they wanted to do. So we decided to walk around the mall again that night. Since we had such a great time critiquing the art the day before, the next day we decided to critique some more art again. Enjoy.
What is it?
Diving raven.
What is it not?
Exactly, what is it not?
But it's the glass case of emotion!
I'm in a glass case of emotion.
Looks like a resistor and then a switch.
Yep. Alright, and which is the swirly? Is that an inductor?
It's a resistor.
It's a resistor? Okay. I'm a structural engineer, I don't know, sir.
What kind of art is this?
Think about pollution.
All the different glass.
All the glass, right?
It's from the Sturm und Drang movement.
Oh, yeah?
Seriously, yeah. It is.
You had the Art 101?
No, I read it in my German literature class.
Yeah.
Oh.
Even though this guy's last name is Cornell and he's from New York. We got a little bit of Civic mixed in with some
That's actually metal.
Ford Escape. And you'd have, like in Happy Gilmore, remember when he goes up the tongue of the clown?
Right.
You know, and then it goes down the tube. This is part of the tube at the end.
Right. Yeah.
This is an artifact from Happy Gilmore.
Yeah.
My father did when he tried to build my first swing set and failed miserably. Because he did it out of railroad ties and
heavy timber
and scrap steel. Yeah. It didn't go well. And this is the world's worst book ever. Not only do you have to read it, but you get pricked doing it too. I have a closet full of stuff and nothing to wear.
This guy matches the painting.
The day after that, our seminar started for the CBYX program. Nothing really special happened there. The day after that, seminars continued, and we met on Capitol Hill to take a picture of all of us together, looking all fancy in front of the Capitol.
So Scott, what are we doing right now?
We are about to take a picture with 75 other people.
Yeah. Right here they are, all dressed up.
They are.
I'm looking fly. Blazer.
Looking fly for a white guy.
He's looking fly in his vest. Got the Capitol behind us.
Then we met with our congressional representatives. I just met with one of the staffers for a little while, which is real nice. And then we had our second last Mexican meal for the year.
Margaritas and beers and queso. And should we do?
There you go. Do you bros the margarita?
You can bros the margarita. You just can't do it with water. Bros, you gotta make eye contact. Bros.
Then our things were packed. And we're heading on our way to Germany the next day.
Are you going to be able to see in Germany?